The snow might be making it kind of messy for some with the cleanup, but some are really embracing it. WMTW News 8's Aly Myles talked to some folks who are just loving this fresh powder today. He joins us now live from Payson Park with more. Aly.
Tracy, when storms roll through, a lot of times we talk about the cost and the shoveling and the plowing and everything that comes along with it. But today, we're focusing on the bright side. For a lot of people, snow means income and a lot of fun.
One of the best parts about snow days as a kid.
I'm sledding down the hill and we're making a train.
The last thing on a 9-year-old's mind is how big of a mess another storm is going to create.
You're not sad you're not at school today?
Nope, not at all.
How about we go this way?
It's all about grabbing the closest sled you've got. Finding the biggest hill you can. And if you're lucky, dragging along a parent to do all the hard work.
It's a good workout, shoveling the snow and, you know, pulling him up the hill.
Now, it's not all fun and games.
It takes about 14 hours of riding to put the snow where we want it.
But even for the owner of Harris Farm, dragging around a groomer, he can't complain too much on a bluebird Maine day. Especially when a new snow is inspiring many snow bunnies to buy their passes early.
When you get this much snow early, it covers up a lot of sands or divots and you can make a real nice trail.
Now others are strapping up for the first time ever.
Enjoying the new powder and my first experience going cross-country skiing with my cousins and my aunt.
So for those states that are still enjoying the 70 or 80 degree days and not dealing with snow cleanup, many folks up here still wouldn't trade places.
Who would want to be 80 degrees year-round? I wouldn't want to be.
Now we're actually standing on Payson Park's ice skating rink right now. They've cleared out a big section of it, but it's not 100% ready yet. Still, if you're looking for some free fun in the coming days, it's a good place to come on out. Live from Portland, Aly Myles, WMTW News 8.